creators, are you looking for backgrounds for your flat lay images? I am bringing you my 5 favorite ways to create backgrounds for your flat lays from a professional photographer's perspective. So here we go. This is part of our flat lay series right here on YouTube, and I wanted to first talk about solid colors. So for the most part, when you are looking at flat lay images, you are going to be seeing these with solid colors. So how do people do these? Typically, it's with poster board. You can actually go to the store and get poster boards in whites, pinks, you can get them in yellows and in blues, but you want to make sure when you're doing this that you're not getting the neon colors and you're not getting the bold colors. These do not translate well onto Instagram. We chatted about it in this video here, and you want to make sure that you are doing stuff that really translates well on social media and represents your brand well. Pastel colors, softer colors, do not overwhelm what you're showing off in your photo of your object and your flat light image, so you want to make sure that you're going with things that are lighter, brighter, airier, and not those bold colors or those neon colors. Poster board is a great way, and if you're, of course, you're doing something smaller, you can use something like construction paper or cardstock. Construction paper will definitely have that texture in there, so it really just depends on what you want, but you can use all sorts of papers and poster boards if you want to create a really cool solid colored background for your flat lay. Now, the next thing I do want to chat about is going to be tabletop. So if you have a desktop or a tabletop that you can be using, that is a great way to create a flat lay background. This also works for flooring as well. So anything that's wooden, anything that's solid, anything that's marble, that's going to work great for you. And if you're trying to make a deskscape, just like this video here, you want to make sure that you either use a real desk or you're creating a desk, which I teach you how to do in that video. So once you have either your flat color, flat lay, or you are working with your tabletops or your desktops, you're also going to want to consider using counters in your house. So use your marble counter in your kitchen, use that granite counter, use your sink, use the pedestal in your bathroom. There's all sorts of fun, fabulous things that you could be using as a solid background for this. And it's okay to have some texture, it's okay to have some patterns like marble, but don't overwhelm it. You want to make sure that you are, when you are using these things, you are doing it in a way that makes sense. So you wouldn't necessarily use what is obviously something from your kitchen for something that's obviously something not for your kitchen. So if it works for tables and desks and other things, but also is in your kitchen as your counter, cool, use it for all those things. But if it's very clearly something specific to the kitchen, make sure you keep those kitchen inspired. Now, we're not done yet. I'm really loving these. And if you are loving these too, I want you to type photographer tricks down below so that I know to give you more tips and tricks from a professional photographer for making all of your photos look better, whether they are of objects or of you in the future. So type photography tricks down in the comments below so I know what you want to see more of and if you would love these helpful tips and tricks for making your photos look better for Instagram and Facebook. Now, after that, I do want to talk to you a little bit about some other things that you can be using with your flat lay imagery. So are you ready for this? If you want more ideas, go ahead and type more ideas down in the comments below. This next one I'm really excited about because your flat lay image doesn't just have to be flat. Have you ever seen those gorgeous pictures on a bed? I love those, and I actually have a couple of tips and tricks for you on this one as well. You can use your real bed, and you can use your comforter, or you can pull it back and just use the sheets. Make sure you're including pillows in that, and it really looks like it's you just woke up on a Saturday morning, you slept in late, you're rolling out of bed, and you're going to do all the fun, fabulous things in town that particular day. So you want it to look very easy, breezy, and beautiful as you are doing this, and you want to make sure that you are either using a real bed or you're creating your own bed, which is something I frequently do. So I will go in front of my big picture window and I will actually put bedding on the floor. So I'll put a comforter over, I'll put blankets, I'll put pillows, and I'll make it look like a bed even though it's not a real bed. And this tends to work better for me because it's a flat surface underneath and it's not squishy on my mattress. So that means whatever I'm putting there is going to stay in place. So I highly recommend creating your own bed, but you can also use a real bed as well when you're doing this. If you love this trick, go ahead and type loved it in the comments below because this is one of my favorites to create something that doesn't actually exist and make it look real. I do it all the time in my own photography and I would love to see your examples as well. Now, the last thing I do want to chat about real quick is that you can use wood palettes, which is amazing. I get them from Michaels or from the craft stores. You can get them in all sorts of different places, and they're just wooden palettes that I use. Some of them are white, some of them are brown. They come in different colors, but you want to make sure whatever you are picking, whether it is poster board or it is bedding or it's a countertop or a tabletop or your floor, or it happens to be wooden palettes, that you keep it within your branding. So make sure you are sticking with your colors or colors that complement your brand colors as you are doing things on your social media. Now, if you absolutely love this, make sure you click subscribe and click the notification bell because in the next conversation we are going to be talking all about how to avoid glare in your photos. So how many times have you photographed something and you saw a reflection or a glare or something that just looked hideous? There are so many objects that are reflective and we're going to talk about tips and tricks on how to avoid the glare and what to use instead of things that glare to make your pictures look amazing. Now, I drop new videos every Tuesday and Friday here on the channel, as well as the replay of my Wednesday live broadcast Facebook group Ask Me Anything Q&A session, where you come to me live with your questions and I answer them while I'm on air. And then, of course, I jump in and I drop new videos every time there is a change in the Facebook, social media, Instagram, YouTube algorithms. So anytime there's an algorithm change, anytime there's a platform addition on any of the main social media platforms, I break that news to you here first. Usually I'm one of the first, if not the first person to break this in the industry. And so I always bring this as quickly as possible to you so that you can pivot what you're doing in your marketing so that you can continue to create a profitable business through smart social media marketing. Come join me here on the channel by subscribing and clicking that notification bell where I'm dropping all this information, and join me in the group, group.kmrobinsonbooks.com, which is the closed Facebook group where I'm in there answering your questions, helping build up your entrepreneurial adventures, and making sure I'm answering your questions in there, as well as doing that live Q&A every single Wednesday. I would love to see you, and if you've got questions on social media strategy, make sure you come hang out in the comments and let me know what you would love to see tutorials on so that I can help you grow your business. And of course, there's extra freebies over on my website, kmrobinson.com, as well. I would love to see you in the next video. We're talking all about avoiding glare in your flat light images. Until then, have a great day and stay inspired.